When can we choose a new idea? It's the perfect second right now, the perfect moment, the perfect second. It is the perfect hour to do this. It is the perfect day to do this. It is the perfect week to choose a new idea, to choose certainty. It is the perfect month to do this. It is the perfect year to do this. It is the perfect decade. It is the perfect century. Century is the perfect millennia. It is the perfect cycle. It is the perfect place to do it. The perfect universe, the perfect situation. In other words, it'll never be a better moment than right now to do it. In fact, every moment is the perfect moment. So what are we waiting for? Something better. It'll never be anything better than a perfect time to do it. It's always the perfect time to choose perfection. Always the perfect time to choose certainty. And we can remind ourselves, perfect moment, perfect second, perfect minute, perfect hour, perfect day, perfect week, perfect month, perfect year. Right now to do it right now. It's always the perfect. So when we start to worry about, well, is this right? Should I do, you know, when should I do it? Keep reminding yourself that it's the perfect time right now. We keep waiting for the day, the hour, the minute, waiting for it. Let us remind ourselves that right now is the perfect time. We'll never be better. We'll never be better than right now. Don't try to think about tomorrow, doing it tomorrow. To think about right now. The right now is a perfect situation. So right where I am is the perfect place. This seat is the perfect seat. This area is the perfect area. This room is the perfect room. This area I'm in, this city, this town is the perfect town, this community. The subdivision, this community, this town, this state, this country, perfect state, perfect country, perfect world to do it right now, perfect universe to do it right now. Everything is completely aligned for me right now. Keep reminding yourself of this, because it's true, it's a fact. Because certainty is always certain, it's always certain. So that always certainty-ness is here right now for us. And it will always welcome us perfectly. So right now will be the perfect welcome. We can say, right now I will receive the perfect welcome into certainty, into the arms of certainty, this very moment, this very minute, this very hour, this very day, this very week, month, year, decade, millennia, century, millennia, cycle, maha cycle, para maha cycle. And this place is the perfect place, perfect place, perfect seat, room, house, yard, subdivision, area, town, city, state, country, world, galaxy, solar system, galaxy, universe. Just go out all the way like that and say, you know, it's all perfectly aligned for me right now. And the situation I'm in, how I feel, it's perfect situation for me right now. My thoughts, my feelings, my health, my outlook, my perspective. Everything is perfectly aligned for me. It's ideal right now. because we will be welcome into the arms of certainty. We'll get a perfect welcome. And certainty is always certain. So we'll always get a perfect welcome. So everything is aligned right now. It's already aligned. We need to remind ourselves that there is this absolutely perfect alignment in time and in space and in situation. Perfect alignment right now. And the only thing that isn't perfect is this video is freezing up. But it's still a perfect alignment. Even if the equipment is not working, situations, whatever the weather is, whatever our technical weather is, and there we go. Let me see if I can get back online. Are we back? I hope so. No available bandwidth. Ah, come on. See, it's still perfect. No available bandwidth. We keep on recording. I don't know, right? So whenever anything happens, anything in your life, say, remind yourself, wait a minute, this is the perfect situation. Perfect place, the perfect time, the perfect situation, the perfect mindset, the perfect everything. Everything is aligned right now. And I keep getting these notices that this situation is not recording, but it says it's recording. I'm going to keep on going. Perfect day. Perfect state of mind, perfect day, perfect place, perfect situation. Everything's aligned right now. Everything is aligned right now. The totality of existence is all aligned, perfectly aligned right now. For each one of us to be welcomed into the arms of certainty. There will never be a better alignment than right now. And we can tell ourselves that every moment, because it's true. This is an exercise to bring you back to focus, gather your attention, and realize that there is a goal, there's a choice that needs to be made. Brings us right back to that. It's an exercise. You can go through time, you can go through space, you can go through situation, all three of those, and remind yourself from what's nearest to you, farthest out, or you can reverse it from the farthest out. It's the perfect universe for me to realize, to step into the arms of certainty. It is the perfect galaxy. It is the perfect solar system. It is the perfect planet. It is the perfect continent. It is the perfect country. It is the perfect state or prefecture. It is the perfect region. It is the perfect city. It is the perfect town. It is the perfect subdivision. It is the perfect street. It is the perfect house. It is the perfect room. It is the perfect seat. It is the perfect right here-ness, right now-ness to step into the arms of certainty. And all of that, the universe all the way down right here, is perfectly ideally aligned right now. Flawlessly perfectly aligned right now. Likewise with time. Likewise with situation. You see, it's the perfect age. Perfect age right now. It is the perfect body mindset right now. It is the perfect perspective. It is the perfect preparation. Everything is ideally aligned. Everything. There's nothing that's not aligned right now. You do this because you have to override this whole thing about belief about alignments. Waiting for alignments. Believing that somehow your welcome into the arms of certainty is based on alignments. And if the alignments aren't correct, somehow you won't be welcome into the arms of certainty, which is nonsense. So to counteract the waiting delay game of belief, we can make these assertions and remind ourselves, no, right now is the perfect time. Everything is aligned. Feel it. You know, the alignment is perfect. Because that is true. It is a fact. That the arms of certainty are perfectly ready to welcome you and remind you of your perfect inclusion within reality. Right now. Perfectly ready. Perfectly ready right now. So therefore, everything has to be aligned, right? It is. The alignment is perfect. There's nothing out of place. And this belief will always say there's something out of place. You name it. We get everything right and it will say, not quite the right moment yet. Gotta wait a minute. Or wait a minute, the alignment of the planets isn't quite right. Or our precession through the equinoxes isn't right. Or, you know, not aligned with the galaxy. Probably the galaxy's not quite in alignment. Or the universe needs to be, have another universe. You know, we're not quite in the right place. We need, this seat here is not quite right. The room's not right. The house, everything is, you know, they'll come up with some excuse to why, you know, why the welcome mat is not quite ready for you. And of course, if you believe that, you're going to wait. And as you wait in harm's way. You wait in troubled waters. As belief undermines your attraction to certainty. So it's very helpful to remind ourselves the alignment is perfect right now. It's a perfect alignment. That's a statement of fact. Stating facts is a way to counteract belief. And, this is one way to state facts, and there are many other ways that you can come up with some on your own. Something will occur to you like, hey, let me just state this as a fact. Don't state suppositions, don't state facts. Get used to stating facts. And so you say, yeah. And by stating that fact, that blunts the bully of belief. Sends them back to their room, sulking. Belief, you know, is sulking. Like, he won't listen. They won't listen to me now. Stating facts. They're back stating facts again. I don't like that. So, perfect alignment. Right now, it's a perfect alignment. Perfect setup. The thing, everything is set up flawlessly right now. Flawless setup. Flawless setup. Right now is a flawless setup. This day, this year, this month, everything is aligned. It's the perfect millennia to do this. It's the perfect century to do this. It's the perfect year to do this. It's the perfect month to do this. The perfect week, the perfect day, the perfect hour, the perfect minute, the perfect second, the perfect moment to step into the arms of certainty. That's a fact. The more you state facts, the easier, the more you gravitate to facts. So this exercises are not bad. I'm not a big proponent of exercises, but I'm not against them either. I think stating facts in some way, you know, is helpful. Most traditions have these, you know, ways of stating certain things, you know, little catchy jingles or something. And you can invent your own jingles. You might be a jingle meister. And you can come up with little jingles for yourself, you know, like if you have an affinity for Jesus Christ, for instance, for that ambassador of reality, 100% certainty, appearance of 100% certainty in the world, you can say like Jesus Christ, life, 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 or something like that. That just life, life, life. You know, where it's certainty, certainty, certainty. It's a way of saying, just reminding a little jolt. Hey, you know. Yes, that's ambassador of certainty. Certainty, truth is still true. Truth is true. Jesus Christ, life, life, life. Or some little jingle. Whatever you want to, whatever is your way of referring to certainty, to facts. You can use that whatever way you like. You don't have, even, you know, you can use different terms for certainty also. Term doesn't matter. Certainty, truth is still true. Doesn't matter how you refer to it. Truth is not at the mercy of references, how you referrals, how you refer to it, or how you symbolize it. It's not like you don't symbolize it a certain way that suddenly it stops being true. Facts don't stop being facts just because how you want to represent those facts. So see if you can come up with some of your own little jingles that remind you, you know, everything is perfectly aligned right now. That's a big one, you know, that you can work on that. That takes a while. You can work on it. Just keep working on it, working on it. Every situation you find yourself in, turn it into a kind of a little a teaching moment to remind yourself that it where I am right now is the perfect alignment. No matter where you are, say, hey, perfect alignment, and keep getting this feeling that it's perfect, because it is. That's a fact. Ambassadors of certainty, of truth, of reality come into this world. You can remind yourself of that fact by using the name of referring to one of these ambassadors. Stating facts. Truth is true. Nothing real can be threatened. Nothing real can be threatened. But you can somehow turn it into a jingle, something catchy that you can repeat over and over. I work on those as I'm at work. I just sort of see if I can come up with something that is, you know, the flavor of the day, something that's catchy that like repeat, and try to silence the other stuff that's going on in your mind. Like there might be some song that's kind of in the background, keeps going over and over. Your imagination is wandering here and there. If you can bring it right back, you know, to some catchy jingle and just keep repeating that, you gather your attention in from all this fragmentation of attention that's going on. You gather that in. You know, life, Jesus Christ, life. In other words, the certainty of life. Life is a fact. No such thing as death in life. Life is all-inclusive. Life. Real life, reality, the true life, the one life. The life that is all-inclusive. That's we're included in that. It's all-inclusive. That means it's all one. It's all-inclusive. There's no exclusivity as far as excluding in life. Reality embraces all of reality. And so each one of us has different ways, that, like musical tastes, we all have different musical tastes. So you can make up your own jingles, your own melody, your own tune, your own catchy phrase, whatever. And just use it during the day. Use it. That's called japa, saying, you know, that's a technique that is used in sadhana, spiritual practice, is to, repeating something, but it shouldn't be mindless. It should have a pop to it. I mean, it should catch you. It should grab your attention. You say, like, Jesus Christ, life, you know, life, like, boom. Hey, you know, we're talking about life here. We're talking about real life, the certainty of real life. And we had ambassador of life come here to this planet. And people refer to that ambassador as Jesus Christ or Yeshua, whatever, different ways of referring. But the purpose was to remind us of the certainty of life. You know, have a pop to it, have a catch to it. It's a jingle. Jingles have a catch. And that stays with you in your mind, life. And then when you're kind of distracted and you can say, in any situation you're in, you can say, hey, I'm in the perfect situation to step into the arms of certainty right now. This is perfect. The alignment's perfect. You can use that any situation. I'm in perfect alignment right now. Perfect alignment. Wow. You can have that wow pop any moment. Wow. I'm in perfect alignment. Wow. And that takes you out of all this fragmentation of attention, right? I'm in perfect alignment right now. This is perfect. Concentrates your attention. And with concentrated attention, you are able to see through duality, and you're able to recognize the welcome that certainty will give you. You're able to dispel the bully of belief. So concentrating the attention, you know, not many of us are sitting in a cave somewhere. So we're going about all these situations that are arising, and we need to be able to concentrate our attention during the day. It's not easy. I've had a hard time, difficult. Wow. It's just somehow we just don't feel empowered that we should do this, but we should. So wherever we are, perfect alignment. Perfect alignment. Completely flawless alignment right now. Oh my gosh, I'm in perfect alignment. Totally perfect alignment. It's, you know, I've hit the jackpot. I'm in perfect alignment right now. And that is a statement of fact. And then you feel that, your attention is concentrated. And from there, you know, a powerful inquiry, recognition and clarity is very possible. Everybody, like, everybody has their own musical taste. Some will do, you know, slow, funky, jazz, reggae, classical, rock, pop, country, you know, opera, whatever. Do the jingle the way that you want to hear it, you know? In certain types of satsang, there's a call and response thing. The ambassador of reality or someone who's working as their proxy or something will call out something and everybody there replies, right? And they keep doing this, and that's gathering attention. It's focusing attention. It's bringing all the fragmentation, all the attention that's fragmented, in towards a central purpose. Oftentimes they do that before the satsang or inquiry, to get everyone's attention, you know, focused. Because you can't have a real successful inquiry, helpful, if your attention is just all over the place. All over the place. You know, it's like, okay, who am I going to tweet? You know, who am I going to text? Who am I going to call? I got some incoming calls and texts and tweets, and I got to deal with that. And what am I going to do for lunch? And what am I going to eat next? And who am I going to see? What am I going to say? And what's my schedule? And how long is this taking? You know, and I got a song going in my head, and I've got all this stuff spinning around. I'm thinking about, you know, tomorrow, the next day, and my career, and my family. You know, fragmented all over the place. How can you very clearly see the deceptivity of belief, the fact that it's a born liar, and it can never be convinced of facts at all? How can you see that clearly if your attention is so fragmented? You might have a little bit here, but it's just all. So bringing your attention in, practicing pulling your attention in, is super important. I can develop jingles if I sat down and really worked at it. I could develop jingles all nonstop, but it's probably better that you develop your own jingles as you go about the day that you can use. And maybe certain ones are like very applicable across the board, like perfect alignment. That's something I think everybody can use. Just everything is aligned perfectly for me right now, down to the tiniest fragment detail. It's all complete, perfect alignment right now. And that can bring in just a tremendous defragmentation of your attention. Because if everything's in perfect alignment, what do you need to be worried about attention-wise? Your attention is right here. I'm all like elevated by that alignment, floating in that alignment, submerged, suffused with that perfect alignment. So call and response is something that is used. It's used. I'm aware of in the Hindu Indian tradition, that is call and response. People will say, "Hey Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan." And then everyone will say, "Hey Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan." And again, "Hey Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan." And everyone will respond, "Hey Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan." Haribol, Haribol, then Haribol, 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 Haribol. Response, Haribol, Haribol. They do over and over and over. It's not like a hypnosis or anything. It's a defragmentation of attention. So you become focused on what the goal is, which is perfect certainty, which is certainty. Certainty, perfect certainty, same thing. Which is reality, which is isness, which is fact. That the intent of inquiry, of satsang, is to focus in on that and to remove the obstacles and the reluctance to stepping into the arms of certainty and defragmenting the attention is super important. It's like defragmenting a hard drive. You got all this fragmentation, you've got no memory, no storage space anymore. You need to defragment it so you have some space there. If our attention is all filled up with all this stuff, you know, need to defragment it. So it's helpful. I may need to get into that a little bit at some point. I'm sure I can do it easily. I've practiced it in the past. It's not an end in itself. It is a means to defragment. Now, I guess if the defragmentation went on long enough and the attention was completely gathered, you know, perfectly, then you would be able to step into the arms of certainty. So it could be an end in itself. I mean, that's what I've heard, is that if it's done correctly, this constant repetition of a jingle that has that, you know, pop of truth in it can actually lead to stepping into the arms of certainty. That's one way that it's arrived at. So as you go about your day, and you recognize your attention is all fragmented, see if you can come up with a little jingle. Just work at it. Say, you know, I can come up with something and try to rhyme it, try to make it catchy for yourself, something that catches your attention. What might catch my attention might be different than what catches your attention. Just like different musical tastes, you put something on and you play it, and a few people might catch their attention. Other people won't pay any attention to it at all. You notice that at situations where there's people and there's music playing, and most people just completely ignore it. And other people will say, "What was that song? I love that song. I want to listen to that." Say, "Shh, shh, shh. I want to listen to that song. I don't want to talk anymore. I just want to listen to that song." And other people pay, "Oh, what are you talking about?" And blah, 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 blah. So, very individual, very specific to each one of us, what we find to be particularly catchy. And some people may be lazy, they don't want to come up with a jingle, so someone else has to come up with one for them, and then they'll use that, which is okay too. But it's best if you can come up with your own. See what you can come up with. But I think a universal one would be this alignment thing. It's a very powerful one. Perfect alignment right now. It's my gosh, it's a perfect alignment this very moment. Everything is perfectly aligned. Everything is perfectly aligned right now. Not only is it the right moment, it's the right second, it's the right minute, it's the right hour, it's the right day. It's the right year, it's the right decade, the right century, right millennia, right cycle, right mega cycle, right super mega cycle. Everything is exactly perfect, right, etc. You know, just go on and on. Keep reminding yourself there isn't anything that isn't perfect right now, that's not perfectly aligned. This is like the big exercise that everyone can use. Everyone can use this. So I would think, generally speaking, in a satsang, in a step two satsang, even a number, you know, there may be some of that call response, some of the jingles, you know, use, and then some kind of exercise that gets us to really center our attention in. Our attention is very defragmented, and then from that point, we are able much more easy. We're able to accept, you know, certainty. Because certainty is not fragmented at all. There's no fragmentation there at all. And that's pretty amazing. When you come across that certainty, and it's flawless, it's effortless, no fragmentation, and it's seamless, and it continues every moment like that, and just, you know, it's like, wow. How is that possible? Well, it's effortless, because it arises from choosing a different idea. And here we are trying to keep belief, you know, try to align beliefs. Cannot align belief. It's always changing and moving. It doesn't believe in fact. It doesn't believe in certainty. So you have to kind of snap out of belief. Defragment from belief. So empower yourself by coming up with your own jingles. You don't need to rely on anyone else. That way you can do it. You can do it. I'm just sharing this sort of this huge centering device of perfect alignment right now. It just occurred to me, you know, today, I think. Yesterday I was driving, right? And I was fragmented, and it just this suddenly occurred, just try this. And it feels like it's a very powerful centering tool here. Defragmentation tool. Exercise, defragmentation exercise. And some things just, you know, clap, clap, clap. Get your action is centered on just on this. Your speech is centered. You're repeating it. Your attention is centered. Everything gets centered on where you are, what you're doing, what your purpose is. Just like that. And then from there, you're able to really focus, and then you'll find out, hey, this isn't quite as difficult as I thought it was, as belief told me. Belief told me this was impossible. No, I'm able to look at this. Belief will always tell you it's impossible to step into the arms of certainty, and you can't even. They'll say it's impossible to even see it. You won't be able to do it at all. It's not true. That's a lie. And as you start to be able to see, you say, hey. I'm seeing. It's not impossible. What is belief talking about? I gotta go have a talk with belief. But don't do that, because belief won't believe what you're saying. You can do something like, step into truth right now. Step into truth right now. You know, or someone can say, the caller will say, step into truth. And then the audience will say, right now, step into truth, 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 right now. You know, that, you see, that galvanizes a defragmentation throughout our whole situation. And someone can say, perfect time, right now, perfect time, this second, perfect time, this minute, perfect time, this hour, perfect time, this day, perfect time. You can do that. And again, so there's no end to devices that you can use, that can be utilized to defragment. Get your attention on inquiry. Some don't need those devices. They're just able to, you know, sit down, so sitting down, focusing in, and are able to just get into it just like that, you know. Because the determination is the defragmentation. And enough determination to get it going, and you're right there. So everyone's different. Everybody's different. However, during the day, it's inevitable fragmentation will be occurring all over the place, and it'll be helpful to snap out of that. We could all benefit from that. Okay. perfect time right now. Perfect alignment right now. Flawless alignment right now. Absolutely, incredibly flawless alignment right now to step, to be welcomed into the arms of certainty. You can use it. It's free. It's Creative Commons. It's free. There's no copyright on this, okay? No intellectual property copyright on this whatsoever. Use it. Use it, use it, use it. All right. Perfect time. It's the perfect time to step out of time. There's another one. It's the perfect time to step out of time. Perfect time to step out of time. All right. That's it for this video.